Welcome to Psychic Medium Toni Green. This is my Tuesday edition, which I normally do not have a Tuesday edition. So this is a special edition of the show. And I'm really excited to be here this morning to answer questions, help you make connections to loved ones on the other side. I'll be getting to my callers in a moment. If I call out your area code, please have a exact question or connection available. And an exact question or connection would sound something like, I would like to connect with my dad, Bill, or my friend, Susie. Not just give me whatever's coming through. You know what? On the show, I don't do that. I don't even do that in my office. If you schedule an appointment with me, I ask you to have your questions ready. It's just the way I work. That's the way my angels and my guides work. That's the way I work. It is what it is. If something else comes through, I'll give it to you. But to start off with, I want an exact question or connection. An exact question isn't, tell me about my next 3 months. Well, that is an exact question, but that's a reading. I'm not going to spend my whole show doing that. Okay, now that once again, I've gone through all of the rules except for one. If I call out your area code, please take me off of speakerphone. And I think that is everything. I am going to go over to the switchboard now, and I'm going to go to the first caller, who is 443. Good morning, 443. How are you today?
Hello?
Hello.
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Excellent. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name is Suzanne. I'm calling from Maryland.
Okay, Suzanne. How can I help you today?
I would love to have a connection with my great-grandmother, Delilah.
Oh, okay. She's awesome. Okay. I'm going to ask you, the woman I'm seeing is a little bit thinner. When she was older, she was thinner, more petite.
Yes.
Okay. This is her. She came through like boom, right in front of my face. She, first I want to ask you, do you have a direct question for your your great-grandmother, or is there just do you have a question for her?
Whatever.
Okay.
No, whatever's fine.
Okay, the first thing she wants to say is, it doesn't make sense to me, but hopefully it makes sense to you. The very first thing she said is butterflies, so many butterflies. And the second thing she said is hybrid. I'm cracking up. Because I try to make everything so logical and I try to make everything make sense. So I'm like, oh, does Suzanne have a hybrid car? Is she thinking of getting a hybrid car? Are these hybrid butterflies? Like, I'm trying to figure out what she means. But the bottom line is, whatever this means for you, you might not know right now. You might have a recollection of a memory of a time when there were like, oh my gosh, look at all these butterflies, or I don't really know. All I can say are these are the two words she brought through first. Now, the next thing, if I will let her keep saying is, you know, they all want us to know that they're with everybody. When you see her orb or her spark of light, her spark of light is like a mint green. So if you catch out of the corner of your eye a little spark of light that is mint green, that is her. She's showing me that now. And again, whenever you see butterflies, that's her. And I don't know what the hybrid means. Maybe whenever you're driving down the street and you see a hybrid vehicle, that's her. I don't know. That you'll have to figure out.
You know, I wonder if it has to do with gifts. Yeah, I think it has to do with gifts.
Okay.
And maybe using different gifts to come together.
Possibly. She, you know, when people say, when loved ones on the other side give me a word, I always try to make it make sense. And I know I'm probably not supposed to do that because it's not supposed to make sense to me. It's not supposed to be my definition. It's supposed to be what makes sense to the person receiving it. So I'm going to leave it at butterflies and hybrid for you.
Thank you.
And she's showing me. Okay, she is showing me, I go to Target a bit, and she's showing me in Target where the cards are, the greeting cards, you know, like the happy birthday cards. For some reason, I don't know what this means and if this is going to mean something to you or not, but she's showing me just cards. I don't know what that means to you. These are really the most vague messages that I would. And she's actually showing me a birthday card. So I don't know if her birthday or somebody's birthday.
I wonder if it's my grandmother and not my great grandmother, because her birthday is 3 days from now.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
My grandmother.
It could be. I'm going to say, even if it's your great-grandmother, she could still be showing me the birthday card to let you know, like, they're all together. I don't know. I'm not going to discount anything at this point.
She raised her, so that would be right.
Yeah, with these messages, they're so vague, and I'm sorry they're so vague, but what I am hearing what I'm hearing is within a couple of days, all of these messages are going to make sense to you. I always give it a little bit more time. And I want to say within a month, all of these messages are going to make sense to you. But they're saying within a couple of days, they're all going to make sense to you. So okay. I would love to hear back and know how these messages played out and made sense to you. I would really love that. Okay. Maybe you find a recycled birthday card with a bunch of butterflies on it. I don't know. I really don't know, but, you're so welcome, and thank you so much for calling in. And
thank you.
You are welcome. I hope this was helpful.
It always is. Thank you.
You're welcome. I am going to go directly to the next caller, and the next caller is 270. How are you today?
I'm fine. Hello, this is Joy.
I'm sorry, what's your name?
Joy.
Okay, Joy, where are you calling from?
Kentucky.
Oh, Joy, you do not sound good today. You normally sound so happy and so bright. What's going on, Joy?
Kind of emotionally triggered by something in the past. And I kind of wanted to make a connection with my grandmother, Minnie Ruth, to see what she has to say.
Okay, so she shows up all the time, and you know, her, I hear grandpa is here, or her grandpa is here also. So the two of them are here, and I see them. And one of the things I'm hearing, okay, so she has some, I hear tough medicine coming through for you. And I'm going to say it the way she's saying it, so please do not. Girl! Girl! Oh my God, I have to stop laughing so I can give you your message. But I just think it's so funny that when someone comes through and they try to talk through me or sing through me, and I'm like, are you serious right now? Are you serious? Okay, here we go. I promise you, Joy, I'm going to focus right now. Okay. Oh, life is short. We need to laugh. Okay. Girl, you know better than to let other people get under your skin. Why are you listening to nonsense? What are you thinking? You are so much better than this. You're stronger than this. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do, because you know what? This has been a heck of a couple of days for everyone. And I do not know what is going on, but people be hella entitled to think they can say whatever they want, okay? And so I'm gonna do a clearing, and this clearing is going to be to clear our triggers, because I want to work with the people who are on that healing journey, who want to be better. And we get triggered, and I get a yes, so I'm going to clear that. I'm going to, there is a source to our triggers. I get a yes, we're going to clear that. And these clearings are healings. It's just your angels, the Holy Spirit coming in and taking that energy, that incident, that pattern, that belief, that program of whatever happened that started this trigger. And it, not only this trigger, but any trigger, because everybody has triggers. Everybody has triggers in different areas, okay? And we handle these things different. For some people, it takes us down. For some people, it, like, you know, makes them go into fight or flight. It's different for every single person. So let's clear out as many triggers as we can right now. Oh, and I feel that, like, pulling from, everybody's going to feel it in a different area. You might feel it in what they call that root area between the hips. You might feel it in the abdomen area. I'm personally feeling it pull out of the heart area and the head area. And that is where it sits, because those are our beliefs. Those are our patterns, our programs that we've been operating on for so very long. Now, Joy, I also want to say, your grandma also wants to say to you, you're better than this. I want to say this correctly, and I know what she's trying to say. Don't let sad people make you sad. Like, this is where they are, and they're just trying to pull you to where they are, okay? So if somebody calls you or says something, and they're pulling out something negative or garbagey, that's what's inside of them that they're spewing at you. Okay, so don't let them bring you to their level. Okay, they might do it for a minute, but we need to pull ourselves back together and go, I don't live at the city dump anymore. I moved away from there, right? Like, if you want to live in that energy, that's your energy. I'm over here now. And then that song, to the left, everything you own in a box to the left. Oh, so to the left. That's all I can say. The other thing that I'm getting from her is that, you know, you're going to feel better in a minute. And people who trigger you, we can look at them as teachers, or we can look at them as triggers. So whenever we get triggered, we can make that choice to say, okay, I understand I'm being triggered. I want to heal this. And I'm going to, for anybody listening, re-listening, watching, re-watching, whenever something triggers us, just say, angels, take this. Take it now. And they will. Your angels will do that. They're in a place where they really want to heal you and help you on this journey. Because we are here to evolve. We are here to grow. We're here to be in that place where we are having just this amazing life. And sometimes in order to do that, somebody needs to show us what isn't healed so that we can work on that and heal it. Now, the other thing I'm going to do is for everybody listening, re-listening, watching, re-watching, all old, outdated, lower energy has cleared from us. I get a no on that. Let's get that out of us now. Let's get rid of all energy that isn't serving our highest good, isn't taking us where we want to be in this life, because that truly is all that matters, okay? So Joy, I'm really happy that you called in because it helped to trigger a bunch of clearings for everybody. And your grandparents want to say that they're with you always, they work with you, and they want you to start taking or making power moves. Don't stop settling and start stepping. Okay? I like that. Stop settling and start stepping. Yes, yes. And remember, it's not the leaps and bounds that get us where we want to be. Sometimes it's just that having that one thought or that baby step that is what takes us where we want to be. Okay, love?
Okay. I appreciate you so much.
Oh, sweetie, I love you. Please know that they are there with you and they are working to help you and to help you heal, okay?
Thank you.
You are welcome. You have an amazing rest of the week, love. Thank you. I am going to go to the next caller. That is 727. 727.
Hi.
Hi. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name's Lisa. I'm calling from Florida.
Okay, Lisa, how can I help you today?
I want to know when you see me relocating.
Okay, so
what, or anything else you pick up.
What I instantly heard, which I don't feel like it's accurate, it just, I know what it means, but I'm going to tell you what I heard. I heard tomorrow. Now, tomorrow doesn't always mean, I think what they're picking up on is you want to be out of your situation immediately. You want to be gone already. I think that's the energy that they are picking up on. What I'm going to say to you is, the way they're saying it to me is, in your mind, you're already, this sounds so whatever, but in your mind, you're already where you want to be. You're already like you're already removed from your current situation. You just have to let your body follow the steps. Now, if I'm talking about in real time here, I feel like, I hear anywhere from a month to 3 months. It depends upon how diligently you the steps you take or how diligently you move on this. I don't know if that makes sense to you. Like, obviously, the more energy you put into it. Go ahead.
I'm waiting on like a settlement. That's kind of fun. I won't be able to go until that happens.
Okay. So what I'm going to say again is, and these are the answers they're giving me. Maybe I don't know how long it's going to take for this to come in. I should, right? Because people tend to think I should know everything in the universe because I'm a psychic. And well, for the record, I don't. Okay. It's not like I magically get every single answer. But what I can say is I hear anywhere from a month to 3 months, and maybe the time frame, the difference between the month and the 3 months is a negotiation process. But I feel like by the fourth month, which I think, let's see, this is October, November, December, January, February, which puts us at February. Perhaps by the fourth month, you will have what you're seeking and be where you be making steps to where you want to be. Now, I think the reason that they're not giving a straight answer is because a lot of this is up to you and possibly the negotiation process. Okay. So if, for example, if you're waiting on a settlement, if they come through with an offer and you say, yeah, I'm going to take it, just get it done and over with, that's one thing. But if you don't settle and it ends up being something that gets long and drawn out and like with a possibly like a hearing situation,
well, it's
going to be another
thing. Not that kind.
Well, what before even for like disability, they can make it more long and drawn out. So what I'm getting is there's going to be a back and forth on this. Whatever it is that you're waiting on, there's going to be a bit of back and forth, whether that means back and forth with information or we need this or whatever it is. I feel like there could be a bit of a back and forth on it. And what I want to say is either whatever, if you, and I hear there's now negotiation can mean a couple of different things. Negotiation can mean they're going to negotiate the amount of time or the amount of money or the amount of whatever it is. So when the time comes and it's in front of you, you may understand it better. You may look back and go, oh, that's what this meant, right? That's the, listen, angels, my guides and my angels say things to me all the time. And I instantly go, oh, I know what you mean. And then when it happens, when everything starts to happen, I'm like, oh yeah, I didn't know what they meant. I had no idea that this meant that. So for whatever they're saying right now, I feel like maybe you're going to get some information tomorrow, and then in 1 month and 3 months or 1 to 3 months, you will get the whatever more information. I don't know, but we'll see. You know what? I do want to hear back from you to see how this plays out, because the information they're giving me just isn't very solid right now. I'm just hearing a lot of this is up to you. A lot of it is up to you, whether that means getting them information or a negotiation, whatever it means. I'm just hearing a lot of it is up to you. And I know this might not make sense to you right now, and I'm sorry I can't give you a more clear answer about that.
Okay.
So,
all right.
Thank you so much for calling in. I am going to try to get one more person in today, and that would be 415. Hey, 415, how are you today?
Hi, I'm great. This is Kate.
I'm sorry, can you say your name again?
Yes, my name is Kate.
Kate. Okay, Kate. How can I help you today?
I would like to hear from a friend of mine that passed young named Paul, and it was recently his birthday, so I've been thinking about him a lot.
Okay. So, okay, was Paul a little, at one point in his life, was he a little, did he have kind of a belly on him?
No, he was an athlete.
Okay, there's someone who instantly showed up, and I'm going to describe this guy to you because I feel like this guy's showing up for a reason also. This guy is a little bit bigger. He's wearing a zip front, like it zips all the way up, tan, like I don't want to use the word windbreaker, but he's calling it a windbreaker. So we know the time frame that they called coats windbreaker. It's a waist length coat, like it has that cloth elastic around the waist. It's tan, it zips all the way up the front. And he's a little bit fuller of a person, like his belly is a little bit fuller. He's a little bit older. I feel like this could have been a father or a grandfather type of figure. And he's saying his heart. So whomever this is, I feel like they passed from something to do with their heart. And I hear cardiologist. So yeah, they definitely passed from their heart. So here's what I'm going to tell you, love. I know you called to connect with Paul, but whomever this is, if this isn't for you, they're coming through strong for somebody else who's listening or watching. I hope this is for you though, because that would stink. You finally get through and some guy hijacks your time.
Right, that's okay.
And this guy wore glasses, at least sometimes, and he had a round square face. So on the sides, it was more straight, but then the top and the bottom was a little bit more rounded. And he had like gray, like the dark gray with the light gray hair at one point. But I feel like when he was younger, it was light brown. So whomever this guy is, he's stepping in. Okay. He wants to step in.
Okay.
I don't know why. If this guy is familiar to you, good. I'm happy. If not, whomever this guy is familiar to that's listening or watching or whatever, thank you for
He's my father. That's my father.
Oh, okay. Thank goodness. Oh my gosh. I'm so happy that you're... Oh my goodness. Okay. So,
yeah.
So your father wants to say, oh, thank God. You don't know how like relieved I am right now. So your father wants to say, I need to ask you, was your father like a baseball fan? Because your father is saying, or was Paul, because the statement I'm getting for Paul is he slid into home like a baseball player would slide into home. So they're just letting you know, like your dad saying, we got him. He's here. And he is saying, he's trying to give you a message. Paul is trying to give you the message. And Paul wants to give you the message of thank you. Your kindness was always appreciated. You were always very real with him. You were always very real and very honest. And you were always upfront. And I'm getting goosebumps on that. Like sometimes people can say things in a way that's very honest, but it's not cruel. And that is pretty much how you could always say things accurate, like you could always say things in a way that was very, I don't know why I can't get these words out, but just like very kind, but honest. So he's just thanking you for that. Acknowledging that you're very empathetic with him, And they both want to say they love you. And they're going to be around now. Your father is the little blue spark, Whenever you see this blue orb or spark, that is your father.
Nice.
And Paul is, I don't know what color his orb is yet, but he's saying thank you for taking the time to reach out to him. Thank you so much for taking the time to acknowledge him and reach out to him. And he's bringing you, I'm talking really fast because my show is ticking down. I have like less than 30 seconds left. He's bringing you a gift. It's going to be in your dream. It's not a physical gift, but a spiritual gift that you're going to get in your dream. And on that note, I want to thank you so much for calling in. I want to thank everybody who has listened and joined us here today.